I have realised something. It's my birthday, young chaps. Congratulations. Thank you all.
I can't believe it. It's Kirby Ball Worm!
Hello everyone, I'm Kirby Ballboard, and I'm here to save you, Pikmin. Here, Twig. I love you. Pikmin 2 takes place after Pikmin 1.
What?
You bowed, so now you must die. Blue Pikmin can swim in water. Olimar is the main protagonist of Pikmin 1, and he's a bit of a slave driver. Mario is not in it.
Blue's suit is blue.
Okay, I have the perfect challenge for you.
What is this? What is this abomination?
It's your perfect demise.
I can't handle it. Turn it off. I lose.
Ah. Curses. Foiled again.
Yay! Well done. Yay. Congratulations.
Wait, Bulbob helping us?
Hello there, chaps. I'm Kirby Bulbob. But don't worry, I'm a nice Bulbob.
Okay then. I guess we can trust you.
To celebrate this, how about I make us some crumpets and tea?
Food!
You are my best friend. Okay.
Wait, what?
Ah, not my types.
So then I told him, that's not a Bulbub, that's my onion. So much originality in that joke. I know, right?
Help! I need somebody, help! Not just anybody, help! You know, need someone, help!
What?
Those stupid mitites are in one of my eggs.
Just kill them.
But what if they're in all the eggs?
I have a solution.
What is it, young chap?
Well, you see, I have X-ray vision.
And?
Well, whenever you're using eggs, I can look at them to see if there's mitites in there or not.
Amazing! Red and Blue, could you please go and defeat those mitites, young chaps?
Sure.
Let me check these eggs. Okay, these two have mitites, but the others are perfectly fine. Thank you so much, young chap. No problem.
Hello there, chap. I'm Kirby Bulbub, and I was wondering if you had a copy of Revolver by the Beatles.
Well, you're in luck, because we have a copy of Revolver, and it's at a very good price for only number 9 pocos. Accept it or be tossed.
That'll do quite fine, thank you, Ringo. And Gruffalo Dawson.
I am the one who knocks.
All right, Heisenberg, what do you want to cook today?
A variety of different things. But first, Pikmin carrots.
All right, young chap, let's get started. Damn, that didn't take long at all, young chap. So, have you cooked Pikmin carrots before?
Yeah, quite a lot, actually.
Interesting, so have I. But definitely not as much as Olimar. He's probably cooked the most Pikmin carrots out of any of us. Anyway, what do you want to cook next?
Some chocolate. But I'll... Some chocolate. But first, I need help from someone. Jesse!
You're Mr. White, what is it?
Jesse, you'll be cooking with us.
Yeah, this is my assistant, Jesse Pickman.
Yo, Kirby.
And we'll be cooking chocolate. Can you even cook chocolate? I thought you could only melt it. And we're not cooking Blue Sky?
Not today. We've already done that.
Oh, all right then. Fortunately for you both, I'm an expert at making chocolate, yo.
Yeah, Mr. White. This chocolate is pure quality, yo. I bet this will go for millions.
Wait, are you chaps seriously telling me you have sold chocolate for millions of pounds? Yeah, Mr. Bulbulb, you'd be surprised. It is a very profitable business, yo.
Again, he's goddamn right. Right, I think we've got time for one more thing, yo. Is there anything you want to cook, Mr. Bulbulb?
Well, it wouldn't be a Kirby Bulbulb episode without me cooking my favourite food of all time. So, I'd like to cook some crumpets.
Alright, go ahead, Mr. Bulbulb.
Will do.
And we're done. Looks pretty damn good, if I do say so myself, young chaps.
Damn, those crumpets look fire, yo. Really good job, Kirby. Thank you, Jesse.
Hey, Jesse, you haven't even said your catchphrase yet. Oh yeah, Mr. White, thank you for telling me, yo. Bitch!
Hello, kids. So, unfortunately, there won't be any Christmas special this year. But, fortunately, we will be reading a fan mail with Kirby Ballborb.
Hello, young chaps. Do you know that only the blue Pikmin can swim?
Okay, I'm already starting to regret this decision. Good. Alright, let's begin with this one from a boy named Peter. Dear Twig, who is the best girl from Neon Genesis Evangelion? Kirby, this letter is a meme.
The red Pikmin live in the red onion.
Where are the good ones in here? Okay, this one's from a boy named Scott. It's a long one. I don't think I'll be able to read it all. Wait, is this a story? She pressed up against Twig and whispered into his ear. Yo, I think you mix fan fiction into these letters, Kirby.
Chloe was the one who ate all of
this next golden... one's from a girl named Jenny. She writes, Dear Twig, I've been wondering. Cole says him and his sister Belle are actually the children of Edge and Blossom. And I was wondering how that happened since it was never mentioned that they liked each other in Twig and Pikpik. Is there a special lost episode that includes this? Well actually, no. There's no lost episode of this relationship taking place, and I won't be showing the relationship either.
Why?
Kirby, I told you not to question me!
Why, though?
Because I promised myself there'd be no more holiday specials. And they became a couple over the holidays.
Your fans hate you enough.
Why can't I just make a cheap video of no real content in peace? Fine. Roll the Christmas special.
So it was a lost episode. You're a liar and a menace.
Hello there, everyone. I'm Kirby Bulbulb, and now we're going to play the Beatles really loud. I wanna
hold your hand. Hey, Kirby. Something came in the mail for you.
Hello there, chaps. I'm Kirby Bulbulb, and welcome back to Bulbulb British Storytime. Today, we will talk about Character D's legend. Character D is an unused player that was meant to be introduced in Pikmin 3. Unfortunately, did not make an appearance. However, his appearance does not affect his existence. Let's just say... he works with Cyber Captain Olimar. Cyber Captain Olimar died in the Steve Saga, and now it is up to Character D to take back what is rightfully his, an appearance. Back in the year 4522, Character D destroyed both Hokotate and Kopai. Now he has plans of destroying those Pikmin that finished off CCP. So what must he do? Destroy the Pikmin planet. And that's where the story starts. Character D attempting to take over the Pikmin planet, Earth, and destroy all life forms there just for the fun of it. Because he's a dick.
This is Bowser here. I've been expecting you all.
A Bowser? What are you doing in the Glutton's kitchen?
There are a lot of things in this Pikmin show that even I can't begin to comprehend. But that doesn't matter. What matters is, I'm gonna defeat you all.
So, you're aware of the Literature Club?
Of course I'm aware. Haven't you noticed this in the background?
I didn't know Monica was your favourite.
Well, you would have known if you would have checked my Twitter, in which I have publicly stated that. Yes, that is my wafer. Before I destroy you all, there's something I've got to say to you, Kirby. Why do you like Sayori? I hate her so much.
What did you just say?
I said, I hate Sayori so much. Because come on, she's clearly the worst girl. I can't just sit here and let him badmouth Sayori like this. No, I'm gonna teach him a lesson. Impossible. How did but a simple Bulbub like you defeat me?
It's because I am not just a simple Bulbub, young chap.
You haven't seen the last of me. I'll be back.
I'm not even going to question it. Let's just move on to the next sub-level.
Kirby, do you have to reference the Beatles all the time?
They're the Beatles. I can't just not reference them, young chap.
Well, sometimes sacrifices have to be made.
Yeah. Like Fiona.
The crumpets and tea should be in here.
Wait, what? Holy Bulbubs! All our crumpets and tea are gone, and the fridge is full of cans of beans? Hey, Mara Bulbub, something terrible has happened.
I'll be right there. So what is this disaster you were telling me about?
Well, young chap, it's here. All the crumpets and tea have gone.
Well, I'm more concerned about why there's a ton of beans in our fridge. I've seen this before. Once on Skype, I saw somebody had a ton of beans in their fridge. Are these beans for Olivia?
Olivia?
You know, the white Pikmin from the Steve Dimension.
Oh, that Olivia. No, they're not for her.
One day there's crumpets and tea in our village. The next day it's full of beans. How very strange, young crumpet.
Hello, young chap.
Hello there, this is Ringo. Can you get me 3 gallons of tea? If you don't get me them, then you will be tossed.
Okay.
Alright, Mara Bulbub, that was Ringo. He said he wanted 3 gallons of tea with peace and love. Could you go and deliver it for him?
There you go, Ringo.
Thank you, Mr. Bulbub.
It has been delivered. You know, I had to go to the Forest Naval just to deliver that.
What?
The Forest Naval. It has mushroom Pikmin everywhere. I could have gotten poisoned, you know.
He set us up. He started his own tea and crumpet selling business right across from ours. I can't believe it!
Yeah!
Let's sort this out.
Looks like he's got people buying our tea and crumpets.
And on top of that, he's selling them for 2 pokos more.
I can't believe it. He's making money off of our hard work.
I know. This just sickens me.
Seriously though, why does Kirby just leave perfectly good records lying around? These could be worth something someday. Well, I'm gonna go ask him about it.
Hey, Kirby.
Yeah, young chap?
How come in a lot of episodes you just have records lying around? You do know that they could be worth a lot of pokos someday.
Yes, I do, young chap, but unfortunately, due to the fact that Jacock doesn't pay us that much money, we have less of a budget than some of their other shows. So that means that I just have to use those records as background scenery. Oh, goddammit, Jacock.
I know, right, young chap?
Well, I guess I understand now, so it's all good, Kirby.
Alright, young chap. Cousins?
Edge is technically a distant cousin to me, because Edge is cousins with Sunny, and now that Sunny is my sister-in-law, Edge is a cousin-in-law, and his kids would be cousins.
What?
Look, whatever, I answered the letter.
It was amazing, young chap. The best Pikmin special you've done.
Thanks, Kirby.
You're welcome, chap.
I hate you for this, though. And I'm never doing another Christmas special ever again. Goodbye!
This is Kirby Bulbub signing out. Merry Pikmin, young chaps. War is over.
Here's Pikmin 1's challenge mode. The objection is simple. Grow as many Pikmin as you can in one day. You can choose from any area.
How did you grow that many Pikmin?
What can I say, young chap? I'm an expert at Pikmin.
Good God! I'm impressed with your skills. Thank you, young chap.
Guys, where did Steve and Olivia go?
They are in my hands.
But how? You didn't even move.
We are in a Pikmin, so expect these sort of things to happen.
Cripes! This is bad.
What's wrong, Mara Bulbub? Has Noah taken over the village again?
So these bread books are stand use.
Is this the end? I hope not. Ugh. I hope someone like Oscar comes to save us or something.
Oscar? Don't make me laugh. She couldn't defeat me. We're much more powerful than her. We could easily destroy her. Couldn't we, Makula?
Who are we talking about again?
Oscar from Evangelion. Oh yeah, right, the worst ape girl.
I beg your pardon?
I said... Oh, you mean Oscar, the worst Ava girl.
Oscar is the best Ava girl, clearly.
And to back her, well, I'm gonna come over there and teach you a lesson for bad-mouthing my waifu.
Huh, what's he gonna do? Knock us over.
Oh god, I probably shouldn't have said that. It was me who said it. Sorry about that.
I'll deal with you later. It's him I want.
I am a very powerful man. Don't think you can beat me. You're just nothing but a bulbub.
You want a bet, young chap?
Aha, I'd like to see you try. Oh my god,
Huh, stronger than I thought I was, huh, young chap?
Wow, this is the most powerful I've ever seen Kirby get.
Doesn't surprise me. He is the god of bulbulbs, after all.
Kirby, finish the job.
Say your prayers, young chap.